The Little Things, starring Denzel Washington, Rami Malek, and Jared Leto. It's directed by John Lee Hancock, and he's directed The Rookie, The Blind Side, The Founder, The Alamo, The Highwayman. He likes to use the a lot in his movie titles, I noticed. And he also wrote the screenplay for A Perfect World, one of my favorite movies. So The Little Things is about a Kern County deputy, Joseph Deacon, played by Denzel Washington. He's sort of this tragic character who seems to have a dark past that he just can't live down. Denzel seems to be haunted by these girls from a previous case that he never got solved. He sees them sometimes. He carries the pictures of them with him. So apparently he worked that case so hard that he sort of had a nervous breakdown. He got suspended, he got divorced, and he had to have a triple bypass, we learned, all within the course of 6 months. So he's been working in Kern County and not in the LAPD anymore. So one day he's sent to Los Angeles on a routine departmental assignment, and you could tell he's not really wanted there. His former colleagues in LA treat him like he's an outsider now. It seems that some have pity for him, and then some are skeptical of him being back there. The police chief, who seems to have been his friend, is not happy that he's there and treats him with much disdain. And even the coroner, she's nice to him, but she mentions that she still carries something on her keychain to remind her of what they did. So we see that there is some dark secret there that has yet to be revealed. We go to Rami Malek's character. He plays Sergeant Jim Baxter. He seems to have been Washington's replacement since he's left. He's a little weird. He's a little awkward. I don't think we learn much about him really, except that he has a family. He's married with 2 daughters. But I don't know if he was going for this weird, awkward type of character or if that was just him. But he is tracking this serial killer who has been killing women, and he allows Deacon to come along with him and try and help solve this case. It seems that he has some respect for Deacon. He's aware of his reputation as being a great detective. Now, Jared Leto's character, he plays Albert Sparma. He's a repairman who Deacon identifies as a possible suspect as the serial killer. This comes from a combination of circumstantial evidence and the fact that Albert, he's a weird guy. He's weird and he's pretty sleazy. So this movie isn't really just about them trying to solve this case and catch the serial killer. It's also a case of 2 different types of detectives trying to work together. We have 2 different styles, 2 different worldviews. You know, you have old and young, you have broken and idealistic, but they gradually become aligned together. We see that Deacon, he's been in the game for a long time, and he's someone who has seen it all and wishes he hadn't seen it all. But Baxter, he's more optimistic. You know, when you're fresh on the job, your eyes are wide open and you have all these ideas and you're very hopeful. Basically, he hasn't been worn down by his job yet. As far as the characters, I don't think I've seen Washington this subdued before in a movie role. I could be mistaken, but nothing comes to mind. He's always great, of course. I don't think I've ever seen bad acting from him. Rami was also good too, but I just didn't get his deal. He and his wife kept giving each other like these weird looks, and I was expecting like some great secret to come out of this, that maybe it was a fake marriage or they were getting divorced, or maybe he's living this double life. It was just weird. It was something that never got explained. Now, Jared Leto, he was obviously enjoying this role that he played. You can tell. I wish we got more scenes from him, because I actually enjoyed seeing him on the camera more than I did Baxter or Deacon's characters. Leto has always been a chameleon when he does his roles. He knows how to fall into a character. As far as the movie itself, it's very self-contained. This movie, it takes its time. It kind of reminds you of A Perfect World in the sense of it takes its time. It doesn't throw everything at you at once. This is not like an action-packed film, but it holds back what's going on for as long as possible. And it does it without trying to trick the audience, and it doesn't become confusing either by doing this. It doesn't give you much exposition. It just plays out the scenes and allows you to figure it out on your own. So I think it was beautifully produced. It's definitely gripping and it catches your attention. It's very watchable. I was glued to the TV trying to figure out what this mystery is. I love true crime stories, so this reminded me of that. You know, I wanted to know who the serial killer was. How were they going to catch him? The movie is also creepy at times. A lot of the scenes are set at night and they have this eeriness about them. Even when the two of them are just sitting in a car talking, there's this eeriness that you feel watching these scenes. All right, so let's talk about the ending. I don't want to give it away, you know, who was the killer, you know, what happens with the characters. I don't want to give that away, but I will say I feel that the ending may be a little divisive. I don't think the way today's climate is would be as accepting as this ending. Now, again, this movie was set in the 1990s, and things, yes, were a little bit different back then, but there are things that have been happening in society for decades, and this ending might not sit too well with people. Overall, I did enjoy this movie. I wasn't bored. I didn't get frustrated. Like I said, it was well acted, even with Rami's awkwardness. I still feel like it was very well acted. It's shot beautifully. It's a great story, and I love that it takes its time. If I rewatch this movie, I probably would stop right before the end, only because they set up all of these scenes that you think are going to lead somewhere. Then it turns left, and the twist, I think, didn't really pay off. But again, the acting is still amazing. Leading up to that point, it's great suspense, it's a great story, but the ending just fell flat to me. And like I said, I don't think too many people will like it.
But let me know in the comments what you thought about this movie, if you've seen it. And don't forget to like, subscribe, and hit that notification bell to be notified when I release more videos. So I hope you guys have a great day, and I'll see you guys in the next one.